to this line. Okay? So, there's a relationship between the slopes of two parallel lines. What is that relationship between the slopes of two parallel lines?
They're the same.
They have the same slope, exactly the same slope. If they didn't have the same slope, then they would run into each other, which is not parallel. Parallel is not running into each other. That's like stay in your own bubble. Hi, Tyler.
I need to.
Bubble. Sure, it's impossible to scratch it if it's not on someone else's desk. So they have the same slope, so that means we need to know the slope, right?
Mm-hmm.
We know the slope of this line, and then we'll know the slope of this line. So how do we figure out what the slope of this line is?
You do this.
You do, well, you write down the
okay, negative 1, negative 1, and 1, comma 3.
And then you would do negative 1 minus 3.
Negative 1 minus 3.
And then
okay, so we're doing the slope formula, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay. And that will give us negative 4 over negative 2. So positive 2 is the slope. I could also keep in mind that this slope thing is the change in y over the change in x. So I can just figure out how much y changes between two points and how much x changes between those two points. That's my slope. How much does it change? How much does the y change between here and here?
4.
It goes up 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the change in y, right? So it changes 4. How much does the x change? 1, 2. So we can count it off as well. A couple of options. But either way, we find the slope is 2. Our line's parallel to this line that has a slope of 2, so our line has a slope of
2.
Slope 2. Alright, I'm going to do it two different ways. I'm going to do it once with the point slope form and once with the slope intercept form. Because either way is going to work fine.
So all we have to do, we didn't even have to do all that work because we just said slope is 2 by just going 2
yeah.
minus y1.
I didn't want to leave anybody behind and let them fall through the gaps or anything. Cool. Make it clear that what we're doing is finding the slope because two parallel lines have the same slope. So slope is 2. If I was doing my homework, I would have just quickly looked over here and said 4, 2, 4, 2, 2. Slope is 2. I'm there already.
Good job.
But I've been doing this for like a million years.
I haven't been doing it.
Just
for a couple days.
Yeah. All right. So here's the slope, or the point slope form. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. I'm using it because it's called the point slope form. It's ideal for when you have a point and a slope. A point that's not the y-intercept. Hate it?
So you do y minus
8
equals m,
which is?
The slope.
Which is?
2. Times x minus negative
5. Can I just say plus 5?
Yeah.
Everybody just.
Yep.
Can we, like, go to that next? Can we level up? Right? You know what leveling up is?
Yeah.
We're leveling up and writing down minus a
like
negative.
Pokemon.
Plus 5, right? We're at that level now. Where whenever we go to write down minus a negative, we'll write down plus instead. Okay, so I'm going to leave it like that.
Sure.
I mean, it doesn't really say how to write the equation. It says write the equation. That's an equation. If I plug in an x, I can solve for y. And I can find all the points that I want.
2x plus
but
10.
Hold on. I'm making a statement here. Huh?
Hi.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll find
her.
That's why you
gotta
take time in the conversation.
I guess I pictured you going to her office, but she's probably
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll just go check Kyle.
Thanks, Tyler. Alright, so we're gonna distribute the 2. Get 2x plus 10 at 8. So we get 2x plus 18, right?
Yeah, but.
Leveling up again, not writing our plus 8 step, just knowing. Okay, now we're going to do the slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. All right, you might wonder how we use this. We did it once yesterday. Okay, it looks like this. If I were to plug in an x, I would get out a y, right? I know an x, and I know a y, so I can plug those in. I can plug in the slope, and I can figure out what b is. So y is 8, the slope is 2, x is negative 5? B is the thing I don't know, and then I solve for the things I don't know. So 8 equals negative 10 plus B. Add 10 to both sides, get 18 equals B. And now plug that 18 in for B. Y equals 2x plus 18. Okay. We could have left this equation just the way it looked, just like this. But writing it this way shows us we got the same answer either way.
That's what I did right there.
You left it?
No, I did the other one.
Oh, you used this approach?
The y equals mx plus b.
Oh, you went this way?
Yeah.
You used this one.
Okay.
Well.
You don't care.
A lot of people prefer this method. I'm not sure why. Well, I guess just because they're different. Other people, like me, I prefer this approach. Because I don't know. There's just something that feels
right.
Something just feels right.
This
something feels strange to me when I could just be done. Like this option is I have to take the 18 and plug it back in. I don't really like the plugging back in step, so I don't know. I like the other guy. It's like complete. It's like a whole thing unto itself. Yes.
All right. And so could you just say the slope was negative? Well, positive.
Didn't you just say that?
Yes.
You asked that question 5 minutes ago, and I said yes.
I think so.
Okay.
So you could just say slope 2 instead of doing the mathematical formation of it.
You mean instead of this?
No, the m y equals mx plus b.
I'm not sure your question. You have to know that the slope is 2 before you can put it into the equation.
That's what a question is. Could you just say slope is 2 instead of saying that?
No, because the question is write the equation of the line, which this is.
That's all you need.
Okay. What was the other one? 10?
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. Other page. Number 10. The point is negative 3, 7. It gives us the equation of some other line. Okay. So it tells us that our line goes through this point, negative 3, 7, and it's perpendicular to this line. All right. So perpendicular lines, what do we know about perpendicular lines?
They go through each other.
True, at a 90 degree angle.
The product of them is negative 1.
Okay, then what's the slope of this line?
Negative 2.
Negative 2. So what would this slope have to be?
Negative 2.
So that the product, as Aiden just said.
2.
1/2.
1/2.
Oh, that's what I thought.
Okay. The way I like to think of it, because I don't like to give a test as the rule. The rule, the book does say this. The book does say multiply the slopes together, you get a -1. That's just a test. What you're looking for, what it's testing for, is to see if the slopes are opposite in the first case, right? One's negative, one's positive, and reciprocals. This one's 2 over 1, this one's 1 over 2. Negative 2 over 1, positive 1 over 2. So they're opposite reciprocals is what the slopes are. And you can test that by multiplying together and you get a -1. Clint?
So basically that's all you have to do is write 1/2?
No.
So you know what the slope is? Yes.
Oh, okay. But
now we have the rest of the equation of a line.
Right. Okay, alright.
Now we have to write the y equals whatever. We have to write an equation of a line. It doesn't specify whether it's in slope-intercept form or what, so once we have an equation of a line, we can call it good. So y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1.
Y minus
7 equals the slope we just decided was 1/2 times x minus negative 3, so let's plus 3. We'll distribute the 1/2. Y minus 7 equals 1/2 x plus 3/2. Add 7 to both sides. Y equals 1/2 x plus 3/2 plus 7. Now, how do I add 3/2 and 7?
Common denominator.
The denominator is going to be what?
14.
2 is the denominator, so the numerator is 14. 14 divided by 2 is 7.
Right.
So y equals 1 half x plus 17 halves. Clint?
How did you get the 3 over 2?
1 half times 3. Right? 3 over 1. 1 half times 3 over 1.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
I see. And that was super easy. I had that and I totally thought it was wrong. And then I'm
and
like,
the
14
over 2
if I knew that.
14 over 2?
Yeah.
Because I'm adding the 7, but I need a common denominator of 2.
Oh,
so
okay, I see.
Becomes 14 over 2. And also, I'm just going to leave it at that. If you do want to do the slope intercept form, find B, plug B in, feel free to do so. I'm just going to leave it at that.
Again.
Because we need to speed along. Let's get you guys out. Here we go. Here we go. So, let's first jump back here. Let's just talk about this line right here. Let's forget about these two things for a second. Let's talk about this line. Okay? We're talking about lines that are parallel or perpendicular to this line. So what information do we need from this line right here?
The slope and the y-intercept.
Do we need the y-intercept of this line?
No.
No.
The y-intercept, nothing to do with lines that are parallel or perpendicular. Let's take a look at a random-ish graph. There it is, okay? If I go to draw a line that's parallel, do I consider at all where this thing crosses the y-axis?
No.
Do I need to know that in order to draw a line that's parallel?
No.
In fact, I can just draw a line out in space anywhere. I don't know where it crosses the y-axis at all. I don't know if this is at like thousands below the x-axis. Or if it's hundreds above the x-axis, I have no idea. But can I draw a line that's parallel?
Yeah.
I just need it to have the same slope. Okay. When you look at a line, and you consider another line's parallel, this is absolutely useless information. Right? And I cover that because sometimes I see that 6, for some reason, make its way into your equation for your line that's parallel, but it has nothing to do with it. It has nothing to do with the parallelness or perpendicularness of the two lines, okay? So when we start thinking about what's the equation of this line that's parallel, we don't care about this. It doesn't have anything to do with being parallel. Having the same y-intercept and different y-intercepts, it doesn't matter, right? The only information that we need is the slope. Molly?
Yeah, because I was thinking that you need 6 in there, then I tried to solve it, and 6 wouldn't work.
Uh-huh.
So I figured afterwards that we need to find what B was instead of.
Yeah, this line has its own B. It doesn't mean that one's
yeah.
B.
Because if it's that one, it wouldn't be parallel.
What's that?
If it was that one, it wouldn't be parallel.
Yeah, and actually, they would be the exact same line, right? We're talking about parallel. If they're parallel and they have the same y-intercept,
wait.
They would just be right on top of each other. Right?
I am confused now.
Well, if they're parallel, they have the same slope.
Yeah.
If they're parallel, right, two lines are parallel, then they go in the same direction and the same slope.
Yeah.
If I draw a line that has this slope and this y-intercept, what am I going to draw?
Same line.
This line again. You see what I mean?
Yeah, say up to like plug 8 and 2-1.
Yeah, you need to forget about that 6. It has nothing to do with our line. It does not need to have anything to do with the y-intercept of 6. So forget about it. Just need the slope. So what is the slope of this line?
Negative 3/4.
So the slope of this line is?
Unknown. We don't know it yet.
Oh, 3/4.
Yeah.
3/4?
Negative 3/4.
It has the same slope as this line. This line has the slope of -3/4. Since it has the same slope, it has the slope of -3/4. Okay, let's switch it up. Let's vote. Should we do it slope intercept form or point slope form? Let's go. Slope intercept form.
Wait, which one is that again?
Y equals mx plus b.
Okay, that one.
We said slope intercept form. Who says point slope form?
Two people.
Okay, point slope form, definitely one. So y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Okay, we'll do the other one in slope intercept. This one we'll do with point slope form. So y minus what? Y minus negative 2, so y plus 2. Equals the slope, which is what?
-3/4.
4 times x minus what?
8.
Now, since I didn't say to write it in slope-intercept form, you could be done. This could be the equation of a line. It does work. It gives you points, x's, and y.
We could have just circled back all of our answer to that, right?
Sure. Not if I say put it in slope intercept form though, which is what I'm gonna start doing. So y plus 2 equals negative 3 fourths x minus 8. So let's just distribute this negative 3 fourths. Y plus 2 equals negative 3 fourths x. Better. Plus 6. Negative times negative is positive. 3 fourths times 8. 4 divides 8. We get 2. 3 times 2 is 6. Subtract 2 from both sides. Negative 3 fourths x. Subtract 2 from both sides. You get a plus 4. So this line is parallel, and apparently it's like 2 below this one, because this one's at 6 on the y-axis. This one's at 4 on the y-axis. What's the slope of this line?
Negative
3 fourths. Our line is perpendicular, which tells us that its slope is
4 thirds.
4 thirds. Okay. Doing slope intercept form, y equals mx plus b. Y is 4, slope is 4 thirds. X is 9, plus b is 9 over 1. So we multiply these two together. They get 3. 4 times 3 is 12. You might have gotten 36 over 3 is 12. Either way, you should have 4 equals 12 plus b at some point. Subtract 12 from both sides. B equals negative 8. Y equals 4 thirds x minus 8. Sir?
What was that? So is that 4 thirds or what? The 4 equals 4?
4 thirds, yeah.
Oh, okay. I looked like 4 equals something.
Because I crossed it out.
Would it be wrong if I went, I wrote the equation, but just put the points in there?
It needs to have a y and an x. If it doesn't have a y and an x, there's no way to plug in any x I want to get out the y.
Oh, dang.
So if yours looks like 4 equals 4 thirds times 9 plus b,
well,
that's
I just
not
put
the equation
like,
of a line.
I put like the 9 and the 4 in that one over there.
In this one?
Yeah.
With the minus 8?
Yeah.
It went too far. Like, it needs empty places. It needs variables. It needs, because if I just put in 9 and 4, then it just made an equation that's just true. Like, this number equals this number.
Yeah.
Effectively, 4 equals 4.
Okay.
Right? So, for it to make a line, it needs to be able to make an infinite number of points, which means it needs variables, places to plug in x and get y. Okay. Now, this is a little rushed, but where is the thing I'm looking for? There it is. Okay.
Ooh, graduation.
You guys ever been to a graduation before?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, let me show you what it's like.
They all throw their hats up.
Here we go. This is a graduation. Yeah, someone can shut off the lights.
Oh,
it's harder.
We will now begin awarding the Master of Laws degrees. Mariam Abai. Bakhtiar Abdulhamidov. Anish Agarwal. Monica Francis Aguinaldo. Olufunfamileo Ayoka Akinosi.
Okay, so what question comes to mind? Clint?
Why are they all foreign names?
Okay, I guess that's not really a mathematical question. Well, it's Harvard, it's prestigious, a lot of people from a lot of different countries come
like
here.
I'm just
saying that a lot of people from a lot of countries come there. Okay, what mathematical questions come to mind?
How much people are there?
Yeah.
How many people are there? Okay.
How long it took for them to graduate?
How long did it take to just sit there and watch? Quiz?
How many people they announced a minute?
Oh, how many people do they announce every minute? Oliver?
How should I set the timer so I can take long fumble map stuff?
Okay, you could read that from the screen. Yes, Molly?
Out of all of the students, how many are law graduates?
They're all, because that's all it was.
Oh.
It was all masters of law.
Whoa,
okay. So Oliver got right to it, and he read what someone else came up with. This is how long should I set the timer for so I can take the longest possible nap before my cousin comes up there? Do you see how all the names scrolled by, and then that arrow pointed at a name? It was this person's cousin. Okay. So if we want to know that, if we want to know how long to set the timer for, what information do we need?
Thanks.
Kind of already said.
Yeah.
Right.
How long it takes to say, like how long someone is up there on stage.
How long does it take for one person to get their name called and come get their diploma? Okay. What else do we need to know?
Where he is in line.
Where his cousin is in line. Yeah. Do you really need to know anything else?
No.
Okay. Well, let's take care of one of those pieces of information. Here's part of the program from that very graduation.
Yeah.
I'm going to pass two more this way to hand to Amy.
When you went to graduation, how long did it take?
I didn't.
What? You didn't graduate college?
Nope.
I mean,
not total farce. I don't even have a degree.
Cool. How did you find the school to
graduate? No, it just takes way long. I'm not really one for ceremony, so I didn't go.
Oh,
but you don't have to go to.
You graduated, but in the same manner as you didn't actually go to the
graduation. Yeah, I didn't go to graduation. I just mailed me my degree, and I, you know, played old country that day.
I thought you meant like you never did graduate.
The ceremony. Okay, so we can answer one of those questions with this program. What question can we answer?
How many names
before we get to this guy's cousin, right? If you look at the back page,
Whoa.
It has that arrow pointing at his cousin's name.
Oh,
get counting.
What?
Oh, this is
it.
So
now we're gonna,
it's 157.
We're gonna
no,
count
one.
And see if we can get a good
it's
idea of an average, maybe.
Yep.
Okay, here we go.
Mariam Abai.
Dang it, I wasn't counting.
154. Bakhtiar Abdulhamidov. Anish Agarwal.
It's like 5 seconds.
Let's
go back again.
Monica Francis Aguinaldo.
It's like
go back.
I got 7 seconds.
Alright, what's your name?
Mariam Abayi.
I'm just going to start.
Bakhtiar Abdulhamidov. Anish Agarwal.
5.
Yeah,
that's
5 seconds.
8.
Monica Francis
7.
Aguinaldo. Olufunileo Ayoka Akinosi. Godiva Monica Okulo. Sarah Almogren. Rosanna Plaza.
I got 7 to 8.
All right, so 7 to 8 seconds, you say?
Yeah.
Just, Molly?
It's 156.
It's 155.
I wrote down the
thing. Yeah, you're probably adding the.
You don't add
I
didn't.
Other. Did you subtract?
I know, I didn't.
It's 155.
Did you add?
Did you do it until the name?
Yeah, I
did it for all.
Does it really
have to be exact?
How many seconds? This is probably more important. How many seconds does it take?
7.
You got
7.
6.
6. 7.
7 to 8 seconds.
7
5.
To 8.
I got 5.5.
Yeah, 5 is fucking.
No, like from the start of one day to the start of the next day.
5 is
yeah,
the start for it, though.
Five.
You want to go ahead.
Clock on the thing?
Well, I watched the clock. I got 20, like, these are rough. 21, 28. Okay, so between those two, that's 7. 28 to 35.5 is, what, 7.5. From 35.5 to 43.3 is, what is that going to be? 5, 3,
8.
So 7.8.
So
7
to 8.
7.8. So it sounds like, yeah, 7 to 8 seems fair.
So should we do 7.5?
No, I'd like to hold on.
Oh,
so
I have to.
So let's say 7, can we say 7.5?
Yeah, sure.
Seconds per person?
Does it matter if I wrote on it?
No, not really, I guess.
Okay.
Now, let's write, let's listen. I can hold you longer. Let's listen. Let's write an equation that will tell us for X number of people how many Y seconds it will be.
Y is 7.5 plus 155.
You add on the number of people?
Yeah.
Aren't I supposed to be able to plug 155 into the equation?
Yeah.
So minus 155.
No.
Aren't you supposed to times it by 155?
Yeah.
7.5.
Right, but plus, wasn't there some time before she read the names?
Yeah, there's
yeah.
like 15 seconds before.
Like 15 seconds to add on.
Let's see what we get. And if there's 155, so 7.5.
Run the numbers, let's do this thing.
Wait, 155 or 7.5?
I'll put it for X. 155 times 7.5 plus 15 more seconds because she wasn't reading names. 1,177.5 divided that by 60 for 60 seconds at a minute. 19.625 minutes.
Oh, that was exactly, well, 19 seconds is something was,
let's
the
see, the answer, here it comes.
Mariam Abayi.
I knew she was alien. She said no.
Kevin Kin Sung So. Adarsh Fargis.
That was him. 17 minutes
while we were
off.
This concludes the LLM degrees.
Alright, have a good weekend, everybody.
You too.
Hold
on,
just
leave this on the
desk.
Send out a
three problems. I will.
Okay. You want this, Mr. Sister?
I don't even have my phone.
Thank you. I just want a few of them. You can throw the rest away.